It's time for another mailbag. Postman's been a couple of times. I didn't actually think I would be doing another one so quickly after the last one, but here we go. And because my camera screwed up, I opened this one. One times LED, it says. Off camera. Well, it was on camera, but the camera wasn't actually working. Anyway, what's in there? One times LED? It's actually a bunch of surface mount LEDs. Red, blue, green, white, orange, and yellow. And they look like they are 1206 size. I have a plan for these. A lot of stuff I just buy because, oh, that looks cool. I might use it for something. These, though, I have a plan for a model railroading project specifically for Christmas. Since it's May now, I've got lots of time to actually get around to doing it. Hopefully. All right, so here is the 120 surface mount LEDs, random colors, white, red, green, blue, yellow, orange. Oh, they're 1206 size. Okay. Cost a whopping $2.18 American, 2.98 in Canadian dollars from 2012, top deal. There we go. Yeah, 1206. Oh, nice, and it's got the actual wavelengths. So forward voltage is between 1.8 and 3.2 volts. Yeah, the yellow and the orange being the lowest. That makes complete sense. All 20 milliamps, so I can mix them together in one circuit. Nice. Okay, next from Hong Kong. It is cell phone accessories. Pieces of nuts. Oh, what size are these? I think they might be number 440, because for some reason they have a whack of 440 screws, but almost no nuts to go with them. Perfect, that's what they are. Those can just go right into that drawer. Number 440 machine screws. I'm guessing I got those from eBay. Let's check. 100 pieces 440 hex nuts. I guessed right. Threaded for RS-232. Oh, did not know that. Anyway, so 367 American, 502 Canadian, from 22 New Century, somebody I've never bought from before. It took a couple of months to get here, but it got here. That's one thing about eBay. You never know. Well, order from China, I guess. Never know how long it's going to take, but so far I haven't had something fail to show up yet. Nothing fancy there. They're just nuts. All right. Next up, we have Module A from Hong Kong. It is in fact a module. Oh, it's an Uno. Oh yeah, I ordered this many, many months ago. Stuff's been coming real slow lately from China. I mean, it always has been slow, but this is like, I think a lot of this stuff I ordered back in February, and it's now, oh, beginning of May. Yep, a standard knockoff Uno. Oh, and this is the one with both the male and the female headers. Yeah, Julian Ellett was talking about some of these. The Uno that I bought, super cheap Uno, just generic. Of course, CH340 because I like that. And none of my Linux machines have ever barfed at it. I know you Windows guys have some trouble with it sometimes, but why is that showing me US price only? US $2.76. That's dirt cheap. Okay, that was interesting. Next up, sponge. Value of $0.736059. Wow, that's very precise. Wrapped in foam to protect it. It is, in fact, a bunch of soldering sponges. I've always used a sponge up until very recently, and recently I got one of these guys, one of these old curly, that brass or copper shavings things. I'm not sure if I like it or not, but my old sponge that I've had for 100 years has started to get crusty and worn out, so some super duper cheap soldering sponges from China. I doubt that they were 0.736059 dollars. Let's check and see. Soldery sponges. 10 pieces soldering iron tip cleaning sponge. From Wakapen. $1.52 for 10 of them. Which is 15 cents each. Yeah, I can live with that. Nothing special, nothing fancy here. It's just... okay, that's kind of special and fancy. But they're just yellow sponges. I doubt that they're going to last as long as the one that they're replacing because it's decades old. But for that price, I can live with it. All right, next we have detailed description of module. $1 0.006 kilograms. Wow, 6/10 of a gram? Okay. Again with the really low and precise numbers. That's all that's in there. Oh, it's one of those. Come out of there. Oh. That's an RFID sensor. And it's loop antenna. I ordered a couple of different types of these. Which one do you suppose this one is? Ah. So I'm going to try and zoom in on it rather than holding it up to the camera. Okay, it even says RFID on it. RF 125 PS. Can I see what that chip is? Where's my magnifying glass here? Zoombity back out again. Focus down there. No, I can't read that. Oh, have to go and check on the description. Okay, the RFID reader. Okay, this one's 125 kilohertz version. I think I also ordered the more common one, one of this style that is more common with the Arduino crowd. But I want to try both of them. I want to see which one can read my card from work, if either of them can. And really, at $1.69 American or $2.31 Canadian, that's a pretty negligible risk to take. From Chip World, I've bought from them before. Never have any had any issues. And do we get pinouts or anything here? Okay, TTL to 3 to 5 volts. Okay, I can live with that. Support card. Oh, that's the type of okay. But no, I don't see any pinout information or anything, and it's not marked on the board. Okay, this could be some fun tinkering and experimenting, trying to figure it out. Cool. And the last one, the big one. Save the biggest one for last, just for fun. What do we have here? Dispenser. and 72.5 cents US, weighs 14 grams. No, it doesn't. Okay. These guys are using lots of foam wrapping these days. In-car, USB, and triple socket. Oh, okay. Definitely not a dispenser. Well, at least it's an electricity dispenser. Nasty packages. Great. Normally, these things will just cut you horribly. But they've used such thin plastic that it's not actually that dangerous. What is that? Double-sided sticky, okay. So, 3 liter plugs with switches. And a USB socket. Okay. That's cool. Where'd that package go? Twelve or 24 volts, okay, so you can use it in your semi or in a normal vehicle. 1,000 milliamps out of there. And that's cool. I'm going to have to try that out. But first, let's go and check the listing. And the lighter plug splitter. 1224 volts. Each lighter plug has its own on-off switch, which is what I was hoping for. That's nice. And $5.68, that's the most expensive thing in the mailbag today. Also from Luckapen. What do we have here? Yeah, hee. Okay, what do we got down here? 60 watts, except for the USB. USB, 1,000 milliamps, 1 amp, yeah, 5.4. That's exactly what I think I measured it at. Yeah, a good thing. Okay, here we are. So, this guy claims to be an amp, and right now I've got it powered off my 12-volt power supply over here. It's drawing 500 milliamps at 12 volts. And it's putting out with a load. It's putting out 4.93 volts loaded. And my load is drawing 0.9 amps, so 900 milliamps. I'll just unplug that. Open circuit with no load. It's 5.25. Do I have anything with a lighter USB load? We got here, you know, one of these little guys, I guess. Ooh, that's gonna blind the camera, but what is that? That's 5 milliamps. That doesn't kill it too badly. What's this one? Yeah, 5 milliamps as well. So, oh! I know, okay. So, that 1 amp load was actually the phone that I'm shooting this on right now. I know what I can plug into it, and I should have had it going all along, but I'm still new at this game. That thing. So that is up to 100 milliamps, depending on what I've got on the screen. Cool, and it doesn't sag it down that much. So it's only really the phone that drags it down, because the phone's trying to pull just shy of an amp. I like that. That's going to be really useful in my work truck. And all that is today's mailbag. I am well pleased with this. This is a good haul. Bye for now.